Hi everybody, it's me, Dr. Kestler from Lorain County Community College, and welcome to today's co-video. It is Earth Day. Happy Earth Day, everybody. This is the 22nd of April, and let's see, my temperature today is 95.9 degrees Fahrenheit and 35.5 degrees centigrade, and it just doesn't change too much here, so which is good. I'm happy for that. I'm happy that the temperature doesn't change very much. Couple things from that I've been picking up today. I'm following a number of things out there, and one of the things that I will be following is we are going to see, I'll just tell you this before I talk about this study, we're going to be seeing changes in the number of cases and even the number of deaths. One thing I want to tell people and remind them that if you have something that you would have gone to the hospital for before this whole thing got started, you do want to go because we are seeing deaths from people who are not from COVID, but from fear of healthcare. And you shouldn't be afraid of healthcare right now. They're doing a great job. I'm in contact with all my students who are involved in healthcare, and it's you know, things are going very well. And I think you want to, you don't want to let that go. So this first study is about looking at getting ahead of the curve in homeless populations. And in a place like Ohio and several places in the Midwest where we are still not quite yet in the thick of it, this is a good opportunity. Getting into the homeless centers, watching very carefully for cases and jumping on it so that there is not a huge outbreak. And so this paper is looking at early intervention being a very successful thing to be able to do. I have good news and bad news, and the good news is now there is another vaccine trial started in Germany. And again, you know, just because there's a trial doesn't mean it's going to work, just like the drug story, too. Just because you have something that looks like it might have activity, when you look at it more fully, it doesn't. And that seems to be the case with the anti-malarial drugs. That seems to be that they're not adding any benefit and actually may have some harm. So if you're taking that prophylactically, if you're taking that for preventing you from getting COVID, it's probably not a good idea at this point. You should stop doing that right away. One of the other big stories of today is that we have been tracking contact tracing with DNA. And you saw that great study that I was talking about a few days ago with Iceland. We have been doing it too. And one of the lessons that we have learned, especially with the folks who've been tracking this out on the West Coast, is that the virus may have been here for a little longer than we think. And it may have even been here a lot longer than we think. But now at this point, we're thinking that it was really not the beginning of February that we first saw cases, that it may have been present in January or even before then. We just don't know. It seems to have disseminated in ways that we didn't think of. And this is, just to let you know what this is a relatedness tree, and it's looking at the virus's strains as it moves across America, and it's looking at the diversity. So if you get a little one mutation or two mutations, that's one mutation out of 30,000 base pairs, that becomes a thing you can track. And that's just how things like Ancestry.com and 23andMe work. They look for a little bit of difference. What is that little difference between these people? And then they can lump you into a various category or not. I do want to harp on one thing, and the thing I want to harp on is be ready for the double bump. Be ready for the two-hump curve, which seems to have caught a lot of attention in the last few days. And the reason I'm saying that is because we are seeing a little blips going on in Europe right now. Of course, we are following Europe closely because they've been through this a little bit sooner than we have. Some places are still going through it actively, like United Kingdom and Russia. But other places like Italy, we might see some, we might see a few blips going in the wrong direction. Likewise, China. You'll see on the right-hand side of this figure, I have China listed, and we do see a little bit of a blip. Whether that's going to materialize into something more significant remains to be seen. So I want you to be aware of that. In fact, I'm not the only one with these kinds of concerns. So is the director of the Centers for Disease Control. He's very concerned about the fact that we might have a second wave in the fall when we have other things going on like flu, and flu on top of coronavirus could be a very rather deadly combination. So that's something we got to look at. All right, I want to switch over to Ohio, and I want to point out that there are some bright spots in the country right now. And Ohio, I'm hoping, is going to become one of them. We're not quite there yet, but we still see increases in cases. You can see we now have 14,000 cases in Ohio, and then there was that huge rush, mostly coming from Marion County, the prison situation. There are now 3 deaths in Marion County. There are 610 total deaths in Ohio, and it seems to be more gradually going up, but we are still going up. I saw an interesting little graphic that I just wanted to leave with today, and the graphic is from New York Times put this out. And they actually rated places based on the growth rate. And so there's a heat map on the right-hand side of this slide. And the heat map indicates the degree of the rate. The faster the rate. The oranger that it is, the faster the rate. The more beige it is, the slower the rate. And what I want to show you is, like, for Ohio, we have gone from, of course, slower before we had any cases at all. We were going fast. We were going a little bit up in speed, and now we're in the middle, and now we're back down, going slowing down again. If you look at Marion County, that's the next one down on this little graphic that I pulled up. Marion County, of course, has a very fast rate because they just had a whole bunch of cases added on last weekend. And then if you look at Cuyahoga County, which happens to be the county that I live in, and Lorain County, Lorain County seems to be still going up. So everybody, I work in Lorain. We still need to, or it's not going down as fast as Cuyahoga is. Cuyahoga is improving. The rate is going down again. So, and hopefully that is going to be the case in Lorain as well. The cases are going down. So we're getting to a point in many states where we are getting better. I'm following a number of different stories. I'm following the prison cases in Marion County, and I'll be talking more about that as well. I do want to remind you one thing that you can do to be a helper, and that is, for those of you who have not filled out your ballots yet, for Ohio, this is probably getting close to the last. You can, you know, if it's sitting around in your kitchen, you might as well pull that out and do that before you watch whatever television you're going to watch tonight, and get that out, because the deadline is next week. So you want to get it mailed before then. And other than that, all I got for you today is to just keep on being good to each other. We will get out of this, and may you all persist like a lentivirus. Thank you and good day.